If you don't know anything about the Village Pump Festival, then let me enlighten you. It's one of the major events on the British folk scene and attracts people from all over the world. Musically, you'll discover all kinds of styles, including traditional folk, blues, Tex-Mex, Cajun, and even New Orleans street music.
На основе фольклора, классической музыки делаются новые произведения. Мы сами делаем новые произведения.
Can you interpret for us, please?
Самое главное.
The basical our music. It's classic folk.
Classic folk.
And another
and
style.
Other kind.
Classic folk international style.
Yes, and we mix it. And to find the new style.
We have and the new genre. New genre.
Style.
New style, new
and
genre.
Also we can play together with rock ensembles. It's good, but we can play like classic musicians in a classic halls, in Queen Elizabeth halls,
you know.
Metropolitan Opera. Yeah. And the same, it's rock stage.
Alan, how did you get involved with the Trowbridge Pump Festival?
A long time ago now, Dave, but at the time I was running a folk club in Trowbridge, which was one of the most successful clubs in the West Country on a weekly basis. And a crowd of friends, we were all sitting around the pub one night having a drink, and someone said, how about having a festival? And we thought, that'll be a lot of fun.
Trowbridge seems a strange place to have, you know, such a renowned festival, if you like. I mean, you know, why here?
Well, the only reason is simply because the folk club was there. I mean, in a way, it is a strange place because Trowbridge is not exactly noted for its entertainment value as such. But, you know, it started because of the folk club and it's always been in this area ever since.
But is it strictly a folk festival?
No, in a way, it was in its early days. It was much more folky than it is now. But over the last few years, it's gradually got more and more of a crossover musical style to it, and we try to incorporate every single style of music which could be encompassed in the word folk. It's a very broad thing. World music is very big nowadays. We've always gone for that. Over the last few years, we've brought a lot of acts in from overseas, and we've always tended to concentrate on the more, shall we say, crossover acts, really, that, you know, that were acceptable to people that like rock music as well as folk music.
His father was a judge, a solitary man, beat him to cry with a back on his hand. He played with his sister. He said he played it wrong. It seems to me, boy, I didn't beat you alone. But no,
I believe you've worked with some pretty famous artists before.
Yeah, I've done three tours with Ralph McTell and quite a number of guest spots with Fairport Convention, and we did Cropperty Festival about 2 years ago.
When Forest School and any phase of war, Jimmy Burns at the
If you've been to the Village Pump Folk Festival before, then you'll probably have visited some of the delightful pubs close to the site, like the Poplars. Something you won't know about this particular pub, though, is that it's actually run by Michael and Sue Marshall, who used to be the landlord and landlady of the Lamb Inn just down the road in Trowbridge, the pub where the festival actually started.
We had a folk club at the Lamb, which met every Monday night. Very well supported. We had anything up to 150 people there every Monday. Mm-hmm. And it was a natural progression to go on to something like the folk festival.
I understand that people were coming from Europe and America even for the first festival. I mean, how do you think they heard about it, or was that by chance or something?
Well, probably by chance. A lot of people backpack around the country, and saw it advertised, came in on the off chance. But since then, it's become very international. And we're glad to see it move on and go from strength to strength.
Are you surprised at how successful it's become? I mean, did you ever think it would become that successful?
Well, I think we did, because it was so successful.
We always thought it was successful in the beginning, really.
I mean, we enjoyed the weekends. It was very hard work.
Well, this is the original site of the Village Pump Folk Festival at the Lamb Inn in Trowbridge, where all those years ago, 18 in fact, the crowds packed themselves into a room no bigger than your average lounge in an English pub.
Sorry now, and if we could change time, oh, I'd be first in the queue. I'd go back to when I first met you.
I think the festival's really brilliant. I mean, it brings together all kinds of cultures and people from, you know, all over the world, and it's a really fun time for the performers and for the people who come here, you know. It's a really good event. I wouldn't say my music's folk music, exactly. It's acoustic-based. I write all my songs either on the piano or the guitar, but how they end up being performed live is different for each event. You know, I mean, here it's really nice to just get up and play guitar, but it depends how you define folk music, really, because we have music from all over the world here today, and I suppose, you know, it's music of the people, so you could call it folk music in that way.
Continuing the international theme, and just over from Hungary, Vasmalom. Explain to me what the music scene in Hungary is like.
Just normal, as it is in another country. We have all the classical music, rock music, folk, traditional music, everything. Jazz, new jazz clubs opening these days. The Hungarian language is different compared to the others around, and also the culture is different. Somehow Hungary is in the middle of Slavic nations, and the music is different. It could be recognized as Hungarian music.
The gypsies play the music for the Hungarians, and they have special music for
themselves.
Benjaminists.
Yes.
In the last century, somehow, the gypsies became the musicians in the society. And so there is a musician tradition in the in a gypsy ethnic group. So that's what you want to say, that there is a gypsy music, and that is always, how to say, close to the country's music where that particular musician live. Like Hungarian gypsies play Hungarian gypsy music, and Romanian gypsies play different, that's Romanian.
Where I come from, you do have to be able to entertain a lot of different types of audiences, because I was born and brought up in the heart of the Yorkshire mining community. And every night my dad would come home from work, black as the ace of spades. And I don't know why, because he worked in the bank, my dad. But I was schooled there. I was a bit of a, like a insecure sort of child, you know, and I went to an apprehensive school at first. And then I graduated onto Edlington Comprehensive School, which is, you'll never have heard of Edlington. It's a, I don't know what to describe. It was bombed continuously during the war for 4 years. I think they did £8 worth of damage.
Everybody's building ships and boats. Some are building monuments, some are taking down notes. Everybody's in despair, every girl and boy. When Quinn the Eskimo gets here, everybody's gonna jump for joy. Come on without, come on within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. Come on without, come on within.
Are you doing it in shifts, are you?
Well, you know I like to be just like everyone else. You know I like my sugar sweet. But nobody's gonna get no sleep. There's something on everyone's toes. When Quinn the Eskimo gets here, everybody's gonna wanna doze. Come on without, come on within. You'll not see nothing like the mighty Quinn. Come on without, come on within.
Rovers are the only football team ever to have played in an FA Cup final on Fantasy Island and lost. And we were walking back across the high street after this lovely meal, and we were accosted by a gang of marauding youths. Any young 14, 15 year old kids, but the big lads these days, aren't they? It's that Chernobyl thing. And I am not aggressive. I have never been aggressive at all, but I can remember thinking, if one of them hits her again, I'm going to say something here. You've got to put your foot down on you. And
the Village Pump Festival isn't just for adults, it's a family event. There's a complete children's programme which includes a merry-go-round, an abundance of sideshows and lots of clowning around.
Oh, don't look, he hasn't got any clothes on the roadie-poodie, don't look! Oh, don't look! Oh! Oh, the Rudy Pony she was looking.
There's another one.
Oh!
My brother runs around the garden.
Hello, are you another clown?
He's Colin.
Oh, hello, Colin the clown. How do you do?
Are you? That's what I'm going to have tomorrow.
Wow! Now he's not. He's not.
Kevin Brown, the renowned blues artist, is at this moment down by the river, waiting to play us one of his songs. How do you describe your style, though?
Very much Kevin Brown music, I think, you know, but it's a melting pot of all my influences, you know. I mean, I think you end up being very much like the people that you surround yourself with, and the same goes to music, you know. Whatever you surround yourself with music, if you're a musician, then that's what you're going to be like, you know. And I've always loved blues, and Hawaiian music, and country music. I love gospel, a cappella. I like classical music. So really, I'm just a reflection of what's been going on in my life since the day I was born.
Well, unlike a lot of roots artists, you've actually signed a deal with a major record company worldwide, I believe.
I've signed a great deal. It's fabulous. I'm very, very pleased with it. I get 3 free CDs a month. and it's cost me £2 a month, but I get the CDs of my choice, and they get sent, you know, postage paid in the post each month. It's great.
When you stand your ground and the world turns against you, you speak your mind, future fades. Think you're on the wrong direction, and the shadow of your soul lies in the shade. Love will return. It does not need to know your name. Love will return and be your shelter in the rain. When the cross you bear becomes too heavy, and the pressure begins to take control, and you worry that you are a failure, and the shadow of yourself lies in your soul. Love will return. It does not need to know your name. Love will return and be your shelter in the rain. Love will return.
Struggle and strive, but what's in your head is a way to arrive. If you mean what they say, then blow it away with a passionate passion to make it stay. And talk about struggle and strive, you only gotta keep that feeling alive.
Flaky Jake, can you pronounce the name of the band for me?
Well, I grew up in New Zealand where we say cicadas, but Nettie grew up in Texas and I believe they say cicadas.
Yeah, and I also say tomatoes. He says tomatoes.
What about Flaky Jake? Where did that name come from?
Well, I've had a reputation for flaking out in unusual places like under tables or behind sofas.
Did you?
And I thought
that must have been before I met you.
Well, it's
also and Jake in New Zealand means okay, so. Right.
So that's the meaning. It's also quite an unusual mix of nationalities as well. I mean, where do you come from?
I'm from Ireland, from the west of Ireland. And
yeah,
from New Zealand.
And I'm from Texas. I was born in Holland.
Let's go and meet West Country folk singer Helena. Is it for an artist such as yourself to be accepted on a large commercial basis?
It's very difficult, actually. It's quite easy to get local pub gigs and local folk club gigs. But to get to be more commercially recognised, I mean, you send off things and you approach people all the time, but it's just a question of the right time, the right place, really.
So you're restricted to playing particular places and particular festivals and things?
Only probably through my own fault. I mean, I could do with a lot more pushing. Now I've got a new album. I intend to do that for the festivals for next year. Now's the time to get in and promote myself that way. And also playing at festivals like this and Glastonbury, which I also play. You do get noticed by people who have folk clubs across the country and organise other festivals. So it's the best way to do it, but I think I need to go pushing a bit harder.
I have with me now Fred Wedlock, one of the most popular folk artists in the country. Fred, what do you think of the festival here?
I think it's wonderful. Thank you for that wonderful introduction, which is not entirely accurate, though. I think it says entertainer on my passport these days, and the picture's not all that clever either.
Oh, I've heard you're a folk artist.
Well, I've played at a lot of folk festivals, and I certainly started as a folk artist.
Have you played this festival before?
Yes, oh, numerous times, and compared, and I've actually been coming to this festival for the entire time it's been running, about 18 years, when it started off in a tiny marquee in the back of a pub in the middle of Trowbridge, with sort of two men and a dog in the audience, and it's grown to 2,500 men and their dogs.
Yeah. So you thought you'd take a break this year and wander around?
It's great, actually, because it's a chance to come and heckle other performers for a change, and you're not actually working. And also, the great thing is, there's a chance to meet a lot of other people who are usually just names on a poster, you know, because you play around all the clubs and all sorts of venues and abroad as well, and it was like he was there the week before and he's there the week after, and you never actually get to meet. And here, it actually usually takes about 3/4 hour to get from the gate to the bar, a distance of all of 50 yards, because you're having conversations with old mates all the way through. Occasionally you get to listen to the music, which is rare.
What would you say to someone who likes this kind of thing but hasn't been to the festival before?
Well, the atmosphere is absolutely wonderful. I think a classic illustration is the local police who come down here and have a little wander around because they got to, and then go back home, get out of uniform and come back for the evening with their families. Now, I mean, that's got to recommend it. It really is. It's a lovely, safe, peaceful atmosphere. We've been bringing our kids since they were utterly tiny, and they used to go and paddle in the stream and sit in the front and clap their hands along to the music, and then they got older and met more friends, and they look forward to coming back every year and meeting people that have been doing the same for the last 18 years. It's just a really nice place to be.
Well, there's a great recommendation from Fred.
This was, to both of us, I think, one of the most colourful festivals we'd been to. And when we got down there, everybody made us feel welcome. And lots of jugglers and colour and life and things like that, sort of what you'd expect a festival to be like.
Our music is a blend of various styles, really. It's based, really, with a lot of Irish roots music and rock music. It can be atmospheric. It can be quite heavier based. it changes a lot within the various numbers we do, so there's an awful lot of styles blended in, but we use a lot more traditional instruments and rock instruments combined, so it could go from slow atmospheric pieces to quite lively rock pieces, anything from Pat Metheny to George Melly.
This is our first time at the Trowbridge, and really enjoyed it. We missed the Friday and Saturday, which it would have been easier to get the feeling of the festival, but when we got down there, we were made very welcome. Enjoyed playing it, and would like to play it again soon.
Well, you've all heard of Butter Mountains, but what about the Buttermountain Boys? I'm off to talk to them right now.
Tell us about Cajun music. Well, it's a bunch of geezers in South Louisiana who originally were French, like what, 200 years ago. moved across to Canada, got kicked out by the Brits, moved all the way down to Louisiana, which was French-speaking anyway. They speak a type of French which is really colloquial. It's almost impossible to understand by French people. And they've developed a certain style of music, which is based in French music, picked up a lot of American influences, including, especially when they moved down to Louisiana, a lot of blues, a lot of country music, that kind of stuff. Are you yawning?
No. You're doing it well, keep going. Oh, keep on going. Well,
you're from York, so I mean, presumably one of these French guys or whatever ended up in York.
No, we picked it up off records and recordings. Steve is a traditional musician anyway. Plays Irish and English music, got into Cajun really via that.
Yeah.
So it's to be developed from
Sam.
That.
Where have you come from?
We've come from Abingdon, near Oxford. I'm Bob's father-in-law, so we've come as a family. And this is our second sort of visit here.
So what do you think of the event?
It's good. It's very, very good. You know, I've been to a few folk festivals, and I think it's, you know, caters for everything. You know,
so you'd recommend it to people?
Yeah, I think they have a good wide, varied selection as well. You know, they have roots music as well, straightforward folk. What's nice about it, I think, is because it's small enough and large enough, if you know what I mean, to make it exciting. It's not too busy and big like Cropperty or Cambridge. It's nice and lovely atmosphere. It's good for that respect. You know?
I mean, apparently it's much bigger than the previous years, but I think it's been well organised, relaxed and nice and peaceful and good for kids.
And the atmosphere of the festival is very, very lovely and wonderful because they enjoy themselves. Listening to the music and camping and eating, chatting. I can't help envying English people.
No photograph for security reasons.
Social security.
And here's an Irish singer who's always got something positive to say, Andy White.
We were there at the Berlin Wall when Mandela was freed. Two symbols of oppression, both brought to their knees. There were Russians and Americans and a man from the ANC. And the light in his eyes burned brightly to the end of the century. He said, the future's here and now, the future's on our side. Oh, and freedom marching gets results if you just open up your eyes.
Your eyes! Woo!
I come from Belfast in the north of Ireland, and I think there's a lot of protesting there about everything, and I think there's probably too much protesting, but there's also a lot to be discussed, really. And I think I just ask questions about the whole situation there, and though my stuff's not exclusively about Northern Ireland, but it's definitely got a slant on it, which is from there. That's what's great about these festivals, is that you have a chance just to see a part of England, which there's so much of England's really beautiful, and most times when you tour, you just play like London, Manchester, which are, the gigs are great, you know, but it's nice just to be able to have the chance to see a bit of English countryside.
Oh yeah, freedom marching, get results if you just open up your eyes. I said freedom marching, get results if you just, come on with me now, open up your eyes. Open up your eyes.
Well, as you can see, the tension is starting to mount now as we wait for the main act of the evening, Lindisfarne. I'm off to talk to two of the band now, Ray Laidlaw and Alan Hull. So what brings Lindisfarne to the Trowbridge Village Punk Folk Festival?
His fault. My fault. I think it's possibly one of only two or three regular festivals that we haven't done before. And also it's nearly as old as we are, so we thought we'd better come and, you know, before one of us stopped. Or so them.
So, I mean, what have you been up to the last few years?
Well,
that's a pretty broad question, but...
Yes. Well, what we always do, recording, touring, television, radio.
I mean, you did the recent single, obviously, with Gazza. I mean, how's that affected your career?
Plummeted since then. It was bad before, dreadful now. Live performing has always been a very big part of what we do, you know, at least as important as recording. And we're a songs band, you know. I mean, Alan writes, you know, some great songs, lots and lots of them. And playing them live, for me, is the main reason why we do it. And when they play that certain song from way back when, one of the good things about these type of events is the average age of the people who come to them has gone down by about 20 years in the last two or three years, mm-hmm. because of bands like the Pogues, and, you know, Billy Bragg, people like that. You know, they're interested in that sort of music again. You know, so there's a lot of young people coming into it, and also it's a great opportunity if you know a couple of the artists. It's a great opportunity to broaden your horizons and see lots of other ones all in the space of a couple of days. Mm-hmm. I get that
If I was to say you slosh, you'd probably say, I haven't had anything to drink.
We don't like to call it folk, but it's nice. It's sort of Celtic-y. And we once got described as Celtic thrash and hardcore rockers, which we quite liked. It was a nice tag.
How do you think the sort of die-hard folk fans feel about your style of music?
We don't care. We don't care. No, if they don't like it, they can go and go back to the tents. Yeah. No. But tonight is for the kids that want to bloody rock.
As you can see, I'm with my friends again, and they really should be in bed. And I'm going to have to stand them up now and then because I've got to go off and meet Mara from the critically acclaimed Australian band, Mara. Mara, can you describe the style of music that you play?
I suppose the best way to describe it is to call it folk jazz. We're working with traditional folk music from different countries. Most of the music we've picked up in Australia from the ethnic communities that are living in Australia now. And our interpretation is not a traditional one. It's more of a modern interpretation, and it takes a lot of influence from jazz and even some influence from rock. As you're probably aware, the two saxophonists are jazz players, as is the bass player. And the guitarist has some jazz and rock background. And the idea is that we're trying to, I suppose, create a new sort of music. Many people think that Australian folk music is just bush songs and shearing songs, etc., etc. And of course, that's what Australian folk music consisted of for the first 150 years of settlement, white settlement in Australia. But in the last 40 or so years, there's been a lot of migration from southern, eastern Europe, the Middle East, and also from Asia. So all these influences are now starting to come out in the music in Australia, and that's really what we think Australian folk music is about.
Nice.
well, from the streets of London to the green fields of Trowbridge, here's Ralph McTell.
When they looked at Joseph's hands, they said the hands of the carpenter. They're big and they're powerful and they're strong. They're the hands that you work in wood, and they're the hands that you work a long day. Now Joseph, he did all them things, but he also learned how to play. He would sing about joy, sing about fear that the people wish they had. Now he heard a voice of Jesus when the rolling sea got mad. He's a boarding and father and he's saving and love. He knows someday that he'll be sailing above Marshall.
Well, that's one of the nice things about a festival. If you play your own concerts all the time, you know, the audience don't really expect you to do your big hit, but you do anyway, because there's always somebody who's never been before. But at a festival where they only know perhaps 10% or 50% of your material, that's the one they all know. And people sort of put it down sometimes, you know, because it's been around a long time and lots of people do it. In fact, lots of people use it to learn to play guitar. But there, you see, that was a chance for everybody to celebrate and join in and sing along with it. So it's been a big song to get past. I'll never get past it, actually. I just have to accept it as something that's there that maybe leads people into the rest of my music.
Is that difficult, then?
Very difficult, yeah. Extremely difficult, because every song you put out, the jocks compare it to Streets of London, which is a little unfair, but, you know, it's a monster, isn't it? I mean, it's just been around and we've had about 162 cover versions, and what can you do? You just got to be glad that you wrote it, I suppose.
Well, I mean, I actually talked to someone earlier today at the festival who said that they paid their £50 with their husband or whatever for the weekend pass just to hear Streets of London.
Yeah, right. Well, I hope they enjoyed it.
I'm sure they did.
Living in a place with time, living in a place where reality is, standing on a big broad line, watching it all go by, but you're taking it all away. The music, the tone, the old refrains, you're coming here to play, but you're pulling the roots from a dying age. Remember the Bois Fumon, reaching for the skies from the barren shores, watching where the village burns, and counting the days since the girl kept home, where the stranger claims it now. Sitting like a king with his gold from the sun, don't you see the waves of wealth washing away the soul from the land?
Here come the clearances, my friend. Suddenly our history is coming to life again. We feel the breeze from the storm to come.
And up and down this coast, we're waiting for the wheel to turn.
So tell us what brings you to the festival.
Brings us to the festival. Well, they just asked us to play, you know, so it's our kind of festival, I suppose, in that it's not specifically a folk festival or, you know, a traditional festival. It's quite kind of crossover in its approach, you know, it's electric and semi-electric bands, which is what we are. So, yeah, it's grand.
How did you feel about the response tonight?
It was good. I think it's a while since we've played down south ourselves. I haven't done any English festivals for a while, but I think it's very encouraging for us.
Here come the clearances, my friend. Silently our history is coming to life again. We feel the breeze from the storm to come. And up and down this coast, we're waiting for the world to turn. Here come the clearances, my friend. Silently our history is coming to life again. We feel the breeze from the storm to come. And up and down this coast, we're waiting for the wheel to turn.
Well, guys, it's been one hell of an event. I mean, for me, it has anyway. I mean, what about you?
Well, not been too bad, has it, really?
It's been all right.
Yeah, brilliant.
It's been all right.
Terrific.
It's been a hard one, but it's been all right. It's been good.
So what about the acts?
Well, I'm going to talk about the acts.
Yeah, no regrets about booking anybody. It's been tremendous, you know. Completely varied across the board, and everybody's loved all of it. I mean, it's been terrific. We don't really want to increase the size of the event, because we like it the way it is. I mean, it's a lovely, friendly event. You know, it's, as you've seen, everybody gets on well together, it's peaceful, it's happy, and it's nice the size it is. It's a nice size event to run, it's comfortable to run, and we don't want to make our event because not huge, all the hassles involved with that, we just don't need it. It's just a wonderful event the way it is.
I think we're in control this size, we really are in control.
We're now into the early hours of the Trowbridge Village Pump Folk Festival, and as you can see, the party's still going on. We've seen some incredible acts here. And all I can say is this is Dave Luckhurst signing off.
Oh, y'all be ready, y'all be right. Mardi Gras, we the prettiest little city on Mardi Gras. Mardi Gras, your name is got your game. Mardi Gras, your name is got your fame. Mardi Gras, you Indian ruler don't give a damn. Mardi Gras, I hate my mind, I hate my law. Said watch them engines on Mardi Gras. Said Rex is the ruler, Mardi Gras, Ma. We the major ruler, gon' carry on. I die, kill I will. I die, kill I will.
Thank you. Over, sit back down, having a good time.